गुड आफ्टरनून।
गुड आफ्टरनून
वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून।
सर। वन डाउट,
यस टेल मी।
एक्चुअली वी मेड लाइक वी मेड टेक्सचर्स लाइक फॉर द डोर। हाउ वी मेड दैट, कैन यू एक्सप्लेन दैट सर? लाइक द नेट,
हाउ आई क्रिएटेड दैट नेट, दैट्स व्हाट यू आस्क।
यस सर, यस सर।
Okay, I created alpha, like a black and white map. I'll show.
Okay, and save as a TAGA file.
And apply to opacity channel, not in diffuse channel.
Okay, sir.
I'll show that. I don't worry.
Okay, sir.
So, this okay. My screen. I need to share. Just give me a second. I believe my screen is visible now.
Yes, sir.
So I created this crisscross as one line and duplicate. Okay, I'll show that. That'll be easy for you. Photoshop. So control N, 1024 by 1024. I took one empty file. Then I just took a new layer, one rectangle, full black. Then V and duplicate it multiple times. Multiple times, select all of them. Also, then with click this button, so it will evenly spread automatically. Merge them, control E, control J, control T, rotate in 90 degrees. So just a crisscross pattern. So the basic funda of opacity map is anything which is black is not visible. It's basically it become transparent, and anything white become visible. It's opaque. So right now I'll just merge it. It's in, you can see this like all this net, all this black part should be white and white part should be black. So control I inverted. Done. Save it as TGA. TGA and then open your file. Open your file and then wherever you want to apply, like suppose I want to apply here, this one isolate. So you can see this one, press M material, this layer. So open this, is choose a what any apply any material, and you can see that then in opacity, drag drop this map. So simply drag and drop it here. Opacity, that's the key. Make sure it's in opacity, not in any other channel. So make sure apply it here, it will become transparent. That's it.
Okay.
So any other doubt, anything?
Sir, I have a doubt.
Yes, tell me.
So actually in Photoshop, the way we align objects in left align or right align,
yes
sir, how can we align objects in 3ds Max? Like if I have two boxes and I want to align it in a straight line, sir, is there any other method to align it?
Yes, of course, alignment. So I create one box, right? So let's place it. So I duplicate it 6 times. So I just like messed up the entire, change everything. So I want to align with this thing. So I'll press Alt A. It's an alignment tool. You can see this option, align. Click and press it, keep it pressing. You can see you have all these alignment options, different alignment option. This one is basically gives you settings. So align and click on any of the whichever you want to align. Click on that. So now what you want to do? So you want to align with only X, Y, Z, all of them. So it will, you can see, become overlap automatically. If I click only X alignment, like only X and Y and Z position. So Y and Z position will align, or maybe only Y based on like requirement. You can see I can choose everything. Z, there is all of them Z wise, it all on the ground only. So by default, Z is correct. So I can choose what I want to do. So suppose I want to align with X. I don't want to overlap. I just want to align them nicely. So, okay. Alt A again. Click on this. See, I can repeat the same thing. It needs to become same area. So only problem with this, you cannot do this with multiple assets. For each and every asset, you could do it manually. But like suppose I want to align this one. So you have to select that particular model, then Alt A or click on the align, select on this, align. Okay. Alt A, click on this. So by default, it will automatically repeat the last command. Alt A. See, everything in same line, correct. So it can be X direction, can be Y direction, Z direction, any direction. So you can do this with X, Y, Z. So with the help of this align, you can align everything very nicely. That this is what you asked, right? Am I audible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so what else, like any question, anything, like any doubt you have, any problem? This is a doubt clearing session, so like any doubt you have, anything you can ask me, I'll explain those things.
Sir, one more question, like
yes, tell me.
So what is the difference between real world and so one more world was there, I forgot the term. So
real world map size, is what you're asking?
Yeah, real world.
So it's basically real world align. This means in physical, in our real world, the scale and size and of everything based on that. Like suppose your unit setup of max is centimeters, but you are creating a object, maybe okay, I'll show this thing with the help of UV, because real world align is it's something to do with UV. So if I click this and open this, so you can see by default it's here. So I haven't clicked any real world this thing. See, it's not clicked on. Select this, switch on this. Now apply UV. So this time you can see the scale, it's outside the box. Based on the unit setup, suppose it's 1 centimeter by 1 centimeter, or maybe your unit is 1 centimeter, but you created this box like maybe 20 centimeters. So it will read this box as 1 centimeter, and based on that, it will increase the size and create a bigger size UV. But this is something we use only and only when we are using a tileable map. Tileable map, and we want to keep everything everything same resolution. In that case, we use this. But this is very rarely we use this, we apply a checker map and check everything, all the UV size are same, and then use it. So this is if you use it or don't use it, doesn't matter, because as long as the UV size are same, it will work. So this is because technically anything cannot go beyond this box. It should not go beyond this box. Whenever you're creating a UV, it should be inside this section, always.
So for applying a texture also, it has to be inside the box.
Yes, it should be inside this. Like that is something, secondly, do not focus on texturing. I showed the texturing just to make, because if you create this thing, because initially when you start a new software and you're creating something and everything is gray, you get bored. Like that tendency of getting bored is very obvious, because everything looks gray and there is nothing colorful, and it doesn't look like your reference, so you get bored very easily. Just to fix that, I just applied a couple of textures without anything, just to make it look like our reference, slightly color wise. You can see, I just based on the color, I just applied those things. That's it. So do not get confused with that. But texturing is something we are not focusing as of now. So if you have any issues with texturing or any confusion, no need to worry. Forget about that, because after this, we have a separate module, entire module only and only for texturing. Okay.
Sir, and there is one more option. Like when we are selecting object and clicking shift and drag, there are three options: cloning. Then there's one more.
Yes, very good question. Yes, very nice. What is it? Yes, I'll explain that. It's a very good question. So I create this box. It can be anything. Shift, and if I drag it, it will give me three different options. One is copy. Copy means copy the same object again. That's literal. Instance means I'll instance the object. Instance means it's a duplicate of that object, but it's still referring that object. And if you modify the first object, any of them, it will automatically reflect to all the duplicates. Suppose I have four instances. So select this. If I see, it's a box, right? It's not edit poly. All of them are box. But if I apply a edit poly on this, it will apply on this also automatically. So these are like instances of the same model. And then if I choose to modify anything, everything will modify. So this is something we do it when we are creating some design or pattern or some shape, like it's repeating again and again. In that case, we use this technique. And like after creating everything, modify everything. Once you're done with this, you can select this entire thing and right click, collapse, and select this, convert to editable poly. So now this thing is gone. So this is what is instance, like you have created multiple duplicate same model, but it's again referring back to they all are interconnected. If you modify one, everything will modify automatically. And then we have another option, that is your reference.
Okay.
Let's see, duplicate and use a reference. So now, it's basically this model, basically technically, like as per the algorithm, this model doesn't exist. It's basically reference of this model only. See, it works as an instance only, but it's referring to this thing. So I can just modify this thing. I don't have to do anything here. and it's like reference when we do it, like especially this is like one in this case it's working as an instance only, but reference, like suppose you have a file, so you can like use this as a like reference and create this thing. It gives you like kind of exact same effect of instance, but it's light on your system. It's not using multiple geometry. It's just one model. It's called GPU instance. Like it's basically GPU cache. It's just same model repeating there also. So you can use any one of them and convert them to editable poly. So it's lighter on the system. Suppose you have this box on your scene, like 100 boxes. In that case, it will become heavy, right? So you can have a, instead of instancing, you can do references. And later you can replace that, or you can just simply convert that into polygons. Okay?
Okay. Yes.
Anything else?
So one more. Yes, sir. So like when I was modeling, so I was selecting, like when I'm using the rotate tool, I am pressing the R button.
So okay.
Again, I am when I'm pressing the R button, the icon is changing, and like the first R button will be like scaling, like all proportionately. When I'm pressing the R button for the next time, sir, it's scaling unevenly, unproportionately.
Yes. So it's basically yeah. So yes, that's it's a very good observation. Lots of people do not notice this. When you press first time R, you can see the center triangle is highlighted, right? That means it's going to proportionately scale. Then you, if you press R one more time, and this is your scale tool. If you see, if I press R one more time, this will change. You can see this changes. See, you have three options. So if you click on this, you have proportionally scale in X and Y, and it's only one direction, only X or only Y or only Z. So it's basically switching between, this is proportional increase. If I say, and like no need to like change it. If I click on this, only X, Z and X, it will change. See, if I change X and Y like this, and Z and Y, so same thing, only X and Y. I select this one, will change proportionately, only this thing. See, if I click this, it shows me only the side. I cannot select the center one. I cannot uniformly scale it up. I can scale in only two directions. So with the second one, I can choose all of them and fix it. And first one, it's uniform by default. So with this gizmo, like you have, like actually previously, like older version, we didn't have this option. Like either you can just select, we don't have this gizmo with this second line. It was just a triangle and this thing. So you have either uniform or either like only one direction. That time we had these options. So now you have this gizmo. So you can just simply use the uniform thing and choose any of the side. Based on that, you can modify it. Just to modify in irregular, like this ununiformly. That's it. Or only a y z. You can see only z, only y, only x. What else?
Sir, can you please show me the option for so that make planar one option is this on the right side. Make planar,
yes.
Yes, sir. That one.
That one. So suppose I select this thing. So it's, you can see there's a broken section. You see, right? It's a plane, but there's a dent. So if I click on this, make planar, it will become flat. Whichever direction I want, x, y, or z. So if I press only z, see, it will become flat, straight. So basically make that surface flat based on the direction, whichever you select, x, y, z, based on that. Like suppose, it will be easy to understand. Let's see if I use a sphere or something. Okay, I have a sphere. Now, in this particular sphere, I just convert this into a polygon and select, select this polygon, this entire thing. And now, by default, like what we do is we just extrude it and then scale it in Z to make it flat. This is what we do because this is like very easy to do it. But if you don't want to do it, you can click on planner. It will do the job automatically. But there will be a lot of cases you have a very complex model and manually scaling will might take a time or something. So that in that case, you can use it just to make that surface flat. So that is something we can use with the help of like this, because this is more handy. Personally, I prefer this technique. I just scale it into X, Y, something. Like suppose I have selected this. So suppose I want to align with Y, I just manually do this one, right? It will become flat. But if I don't want to do it, I can use a make plane. You can see, it will make take the average of X, Y, Z and make it a flat. But if I want to do it in Y direction, you can see I click Y, it becomes perfectly flat, the surface. Perfect flat in Y direction. Similarly, I can select any one of few of them, make plane Z direction, see? So make it a flat surface for that. And like what else will...
So like one more question. So the polygons are highlighted. So if I want to select the edges, so is there any other shortcut like directly from the polygons,
you want to convert this selection of polygon to edge mode, right?
Yes,
press control from keyboard and click whichever you want. You want to select edges, click on the edge. It will convert that selection into edge. If you want to convert this into vertex, control, click on the vertex. You can convert that.
Because previously I was doing it manually and it was taking too much time. So, I got it.
I guess what I showed this initially. Okay, anyways, during class, we didn't use it. But initially when I explaining it, that time I explained this. It's okay, no problem. So like we can do this with the help of this. And now vertex is there, control. But if you see, from vertex to if I go to face, it will select these faces also. Reason, this vertex is part of this particular face also, right? So it will based on the vertex edge and all this thing, it will select those sections. We can do this. And one more thing, I just remember something.
Sir, one doubt.
Yes.
In edge mode, we have connect, flow connect and disconnect. There are three options there. These three are working the same or differentiate from each other.
Are you talking about this?
No, sir. In the top of the, yeah. Like top set one. Flow, nearby set flow, disconnect, disconnect and flow connect. Right side, sir. Yeah, that one. Sir.
Okay. This one. Connect, distance connect and flow connect. So if you connect it, it will create a loop, one connect all three of them. If you click this, nothing happens. Like the reason, I guess, if I have to select all of them, So if I select this one and this one, to create this entire loop based on that, it's because this is continuous loop. That's why it's basically using that entire poly loop and creating this thing. You don't have to select all the edges manually. Or maybe suppose you have something. Let's see. If I select. This thing, and let's see if I select this one and this one and click on this, you can see it will read the entire loop and generate, connect the entire loop basically. That's particular surface from where to where. It can be you have open-ended this thing, therefore that also can, it will work perfectly. And there's one more thing is there, this one, your flow connect. So if you, flow is basically based on the flow of that particular, this thing. You can see, if you hover over any of the option, you see, it will show you this thing very easily. This like how, what is the option, like usage of that particular thing. It basically makes everything smooth. Like suppose, let's see. Select few of the edges, then click it. So it will create a loop here, and based on the flow, you can see sides, they become slightly wide. So with like based on the shape of the model, it will be smooth, and it will take the volume as well. It will consider the volume, and based on that, it will create that. It will be easy to understand if I create a bottle or something, or maybe some. Let's see. Polygon, delete this. Now I select this one. Control double click to select the entire ring, and I can click on the flow. So you can see it will. This volume will become slightly wide. So then you can manually modify it. Usually it works on the edges and all, like wherever you have like really complex shapes, something like this, and you want to make it a little smoother. In that case, it works beautifully. You see, it makes this thing slightly, like it matches the flow of the model and shape and everything. Similarly, it's like this. So this is almost fine. If I change it like this, oh, sorry, my bad. See, it becomes slightly edge flow. This is called edge flow basically. With edge flow, it becomes average out this distance and fix it. Like this, you can like, this is you can, this is uses wise, you can, yes, definitely you can use and make this thing it's like really handy way to do it. Like if you want to smooth some surface or something, for that, those things it's pretty simple and handy. Yeah.
Okay.
Anything else?
Sir, one last question.
Yes.
So, like in many of my models, I've noticed one thing. Like so when I'm making it a polygon, like the model is made up of many polygons.
Mm-hmm.
And as you already said, a polygon is made up of two triangles.
Yes.
So in many of the polygons, like I'm noticing there is a slight diagonal kind of effect is coming from the triangle. So how can I smoothen it? Like, is there any way to smoothen it?
I guess you mean this thing. Like if I select this one and move it like this. So you can see this is what you're talking about, right? This kind of bend creates without any edge, right?
Yes, sir.
right? This is what you're talking about. That means it's a pinch. So this kind of pinch are not allowed because this is basically breaking the polygon. Because right now there is no edge to hold this shape. And it's a non-planar face. So to whenever you have something like this, if you want to fix this, you can use make planar. So it will fix that broken shape. So now this will be a flat plane. So with this make planar, you can fix those things. Because it was a non-planar face, planar face is basically flat, rectangular or square shape. So if there's a spike in your model and without any supporting edge, it's breaking into two triangles. It's a wrong geometry. So in that case, you select that face and make it a planar face. It basically to convert that shape into a planar. So, this planar, yes?
So can you please repeat? So your voice is breaking. Can you please repeat?
Okay. I'll do this. So here you can see it's in, okay, let me, I invert and delete everything. So here you can see clearly this particular plane, this particular surface, there is a line. You can see there's no edge, but it's bending, right? Same here, it's bending outside, this one bending inside. So whenever something like this happens, this is a wrong geometry. So this is something because if you have something shaped like this, either you connect these two, now it's correct. Similarly, connect these two, then it's correct. But without this edge, if it's bending, then it's a problem. The reason behind it is whenever you import a model into a game engine, it triangulates automatically. So if you don't have a supporting edge here and it's a non-planar polygon, planar means flat polygons. So it's not a flat. I can see there is a bend here. It's not a flat polygon. So if I import this into a game engine, so it will triangulate, but I don't know how it's going to triangulate. Maybe it will triangulate from this edge to this edge, but what if it triangulates from this point to this point? You can see the shape will change. It was going inside previously, now it's coming outside. Similarly, now it's, you can see it's coming outside. If I select this one and connect it, it will go inside. So what if it will auto triangulate, so it will create this problem. So then what will happen? It will start creating shading in engine. So that's a problem. So that's why non-planar faces are not acceptable. So what we do to fix it, select this plane. So we can see this bend is there. Click on planar. Now you can see it's a flat surface. There is no bend at all. Similarly, select this, make a planar, no bend at all. So perfect shape. So on without an edge, it cannot bend. It can bend, but technically it's incorrect. If it's bending, either triangulate that section or make it a selected polygon and convert that into a planar. Okay.
Okay, so whenever we are making a model, it should be plain, like there should be no problem.
Yes.
So we transport import it to the game engine.
Yes, so, because whatever we're doing, it's for gaming, right? So yes. Everything should be optimized for games. So anything anything that will create a problem in game engine should be avoided. So that's why we avoid all this thing. Like spikes should not be there. Any kind of I'll do this. So now you can see we have this bend, this thing. So there is something, there's one more modifier called STL check. It's basically checking your model. STL check. Click on this. You can see in this option, the errors, open edges, double face, spikes. If I click on spike and click on check, it by default showing no this thing. but it's just this thing is a spike because there is only two polygons. So if there is like there's only two polygons, nothing more, that's why it's not showing any error. So I'll just undo this. Let me show it with this some decent mode sphere. Okay, and convert this into a polygon edge, select one vertex, and so it's become a spike, right? It's a very unusual shape because this is wrong. You can see it's creating shading already. You can see black shading, it's creating problem already. So I can make multiple spikes on my model. Spikes. Now I'll go and select STL check. Spikes check. So sorry, still showing no error. Very strange. This is strange. Like it should select this particular faces. But it's not showing any error. That is strange. It usually selects. One sec. Selection. Polygon face mode. Concave or convex. So with the help of this, I can like find this also fine, but that STL should work. Why is STL didn't work? And like if you have a non-planar surface or you have like n-gons. N-gons means anything more than four sides. So there is no n-gon basically. Yeah, now it's 3 points. Anything, only three side. You can see automatically selected. So it selects. So suppose I create, let's see. And connect this. This become n-gon. Polygon. Pi. Click on this. See. Four sides are acceptable. Anything more than four, that means this two faces have problem. At STL check, I'll check on why it's not working. I'm really not sure because whenever you click STL check, it basically shows all the errors in your model. If there's any error or any issue or anything, it shows that, but it's not showing any error for spikes. That's strange. But let me see if I select this also. It's like entirely wrong geometry. Still not showing any error. I guess I have to reinstall my Max or what? Like it should select this too. All these spikes, it should select those spikes and show. Let's see, there's an option for check and select faces are on. So it should select these faces and show me this is an error. But I don't know, due to some strange reason, it's not showing me any error. Let's see if I go back. Need something. Only open edges. It's showing only open edges, nothing else. Okay, I'll cross check this. I don't know why it's not working. It should work. The spikes, those spikes are not basically not acceptable. Let's check everything. And like, okay, what else?
are only this much up.
And Prem, you have anything, any doubts or anything?
No, sir.
Okay, then totally good. Very nice. Okay, then I'll see you guys Monday.
Okay, sir.
And
so, upload this video.
Yes, all the videos I'll upload today only. Yes.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay, welcome.